Kampala police spokesperson Patrick Onyango has revealed that four more bodies have been recovered today, raising the death toll to 34. According to Onyango, the victims have been identified as Leticia Nasiwa, Benita Nakalema, Simon Katerega, and Maureen Nachito, who were all identified by Nakabiri Margaret, a resident of Bukomero in Chiboga district, and Lukanga Fred. Onyango stated that Mulago Hospital mortuary is stranded with seven of the dead bodies that were recovered between Saturday and Wednesday from Chitezi Gabet landfill site, adding that currently 29 people are still missing. Onyango said that the operational team that is overseeing the rescue mission at Chitezi landfill is happy with the way the work is moving on, adding that the team has received necessary support from the government, the Uganda Red Cross, and different stakeholders. The rescue team is, however, facing the challenge of a waterlogged site. The operators of the earth-moving equipment had to first create a channel for water to flow, an activity which slowed the retrieval efforts. The Uganda National Examinations Board has released research findings about the adoption of the new curriculum in schools across the country. According to Tony Muzale, the head of research at UNEP, following the research made in March and April this year in a sample space of 300 schools across the country, the findings indicate that 80% of the teachers have no experience in teaching the new curriculum, the reason why most of them are still delivering lessons based on the old curriculum.
We thought they were going to use the learner-centered methods, and the learner-centered method focuses on inquiry-based learning, participatory applications in teaching, and also it focuses on discovery learning, and then also the level of involvement, the interaction between the teacher, because it should not be a one-way, it should be a two-way approach. But we found that most of the teachers, actually the majority of the teachers, were still implementing the old curriculum. So these were some of the gaps that we found on the ground.
More findings in this research indicate that 58% of students believe that the teachers are not familiar with the new curriculum, against 41% who believe that the teachers are familiar with the new curriculum. Whereas the research indicates this finding, Muzale said that students shall sit exams based on the new curriculum and expresses optimism that they will pass the exams. He also emphasized the need for mindset change among the teachers.
We found out that teachers still have issues when it comes to formulation of HOTS, or what I would call higher order thinking questions. Kwakati mindset, umuzungu chaita mindset chechukuru enyo.
The chairperson of the Uganda National Examinations Board, Professor Celestino Obua, revealed that they are challenged by limited funds to aid in the processes of training teachers across the country about the execution of the new curriculum. He says that they are considering training teachers across the country using the Zoom online platform.
Now, training these days can be done in person, but training can also be done online, where possible, through communication, because we need to find a way of communicating with the schools, with the teachers.
The World Health Organization yesterday declared the Mpox surge in Africa was now a global public health emergency, sounding its highest possible alarm over the worsening situation. This follows an emergency committee convened by the WHO amidst concerns that a deadlier strain of the virus, clad Ivy, had reached four previously unaffected countries in Africa. The WHO chief Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus told press conference.
The detection and rapid spread of a new clade of Mpox in eastern DRC, its detection in neighboring countries that had not previously reported Mpox, and the potential for further spread within Africa and beyond is very worrying.
Since the beginning of the year, more than 17,000 Mpox cases and more than 500 deaths have been reported in 13 countries in Africa, according to the Africa Center for Disease Control and Prevention, which clarifies the outbreak as a very high-risk event. The highest number of cases are among 14,000 in DR Congo, which reported 96% of the confirmed cases this month.
The emergency committee met and advised me that, in its view, the situation constitutes a public health emergency of international concern. I have accepted that advice.
Mpox, formerly known as monkeypox, is a viral disease that can spread easily between people and from infected animals. It can spread through close contact, such as touching, kissing, or sex, as well as through contaminated materials like sheets, clothing, and needles, according to WHO. Symptoms include a fever, a painful rash, headache, muscle and back pain, low energy, and an enlarged lymph node. 500,000 doses of the vaccine are in stock, and another 2.4 million could be produced by the end of the year, according to Tim Nguyen, the WHO Health Emergencies Program. The organization emphasized that vaccines are only part of the response. Containing the spread will also require increased surveillance, diagnostics, and research to fill gaps in understanding.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.